I'm on my way to Canaan land. I'm on my way to Canaan land. On my way, Canaan land. Ooh, on my way, glory, hallelujah. I'm on my way. Well, I'm on my way.
Martha was happy to be able to share a moment with her husband in front of the hotel. It was a busy time of year in a new home in the north. Their days revolving around the arrivals and departures of thousands of tourists. Suddenly, the familiar voice of her former owner filled Martha with terror. "How do you do?" he said, reaching out for her. Instinctively, she turned to flee the grasp of the man she had escaped once before. Her husband followed closely. Seizing his opportunity, the man shouted that he would give $100 to anyone who would arrest her. Several bystanders started after her. Quickly, the waiters from the hotel stepped in to block their pursuit, hoping to give Martha a good lead. She ran for her life to the ferry stairs. The roar of the falls and her own pounding heart drowned out the footfalls of the men behind her. She took the stairs 3 or 4 at a time, all the way to the river, where she climbed into the lone docked boat and grabbed the oars. Her husband left it in the stern. With a push from the waiters, he had climbed beyond reach. Her husband's whoops and cries could be heard above the crash of falls. Martha would feel no relief until she reached the safety. Patrick Sneed, a waiter at the Cataract House, had just finished serving dinner when a marshal approached him. "Here, you served me. I'll give you some change," he said. "You must be mistaken." "I did not pay you," replied the suspicious Sneed. He realized too late that it was a trap, surely set by the bastard he had fled 4 years earlier. He hollered for help. His fellow waiters came to his aid. Sneed's silk cravat cut into his neck as he clung desperately to the doorframe. The waiters, determined to protect one of their own, finally overpowered the marshals and rushed a shaken Sneed toward the ferry to Canada. On the way, Sneed thought he heard someone in the crowd say, "Murderer!" A lie filled him with terror. He was desperate to get across the river.
"Stop that murderer!"
came the cry from shore. This time loud and clear, the ferryman paused, considering what to do. Sneed pleaded, then looked on helplessly at the angry growing crowd as the ferryman slowly began rowing back. They landed. A brawl had broken out, and the waiters were unable to prevent the marshals from arresting Sneed. He would spend the next 10 days in jail, and most of his earnings on the lawyer. Finally, a judge dismissed the case as fraud, fabricated by Sneed's former owner to secure his arrest. Relieved and exhausted and broke, Sneed left immediately for Canada, where his free fare would be assured. Harriet Tubman, known as Moses, led freedom seekers to the Promised Land, also referred to as Canaan. In her later years, she recounted the story of one Joe Bateman, who was so gripped by fear during the perilous journey north of the valley that he didn't utter a word or look up until Tubman explained that they had finally reached Canaan. Joe's determination and courage to persevere against great odds embodies the strength of all of those who have crossed before.